Mothers having twins have been urged to have their babies 3 weeks ahead of full term. An extensive Australian study has found twins born after 37 weeks are three times more likely to have complications.
At just 10 days old, Jack and Ethan Smith are quite a handful. But mother Ashley says the identical twins were given the best start to life because she had them early.
As we got further along, my obstetrician suggested that we take them out at 37 weeks.
That's 3 weeks before full term, the exact time a new study recommends. The 9-year project involving 235 women found those who give birth to twins at 37 weeks through caesarean or induced delivery are 60% less likely to have complications.
Every week after 37 weeks, there's an increased risk of stillbirth, increased risk of nursery admission and other adverse health outcomes.
Researchers suspect the more time twins spend in the womb, the more likely they are to be deprived of essential nutrients. That can lead to low birth weight and medical problems later in life.
There's a very strong association between being growth restricted at birth and having an increased risk of obesity, cardiovascular disease and diabetes.
Researchers now hope to have national guidelines implemented so that mothers everywhere can be made aware of the advice.
To have a study like this come out with such a definitive result that will make an impact and a difference for young mothers, it's terrific.
When you're going down the road of a twin pregnancy, you don't know a lot, so any sort of research that can help and help you make up your mind to produce healthy babies at the end is excellent.
Jessica Braithwaite, 10 News.
Many survivors of breast cancer no sooner get over one major hurdle when they face another, massive permanent fluid buildup related to their surgery. Now, for the first time in Australia, a radical treatment is offering them a solution.
Megan Southwell was only 36 when diagnosed with breast cancer 5 years ago. She had chemo and radiotherapy, and because the cancer had spread to the lymph glands under her arm, surgeons removed those as well.
And just before my treatment had finished, so getting quite close towards the end, another little speed hump appeared, and that's when I developed lymphedema.
There's been no drug or surgery to treat the debilitating swelling affecting around 40% of breast cancer survivors. So Megan jumped at the chance to undergo a radical solution using liposuction at Macquarie University Cancer Institute.
I put my hand up so fast.
Doctors have discovered through MRI imaging and cell testing that lymphedema, long thought to be mainly fluid, is in fact mostly abnormal fat.
I think the fluid is in fact releasing certain growth factors called cytokines, which is stimulating the stem cells of the fat to grow and deposit fat there.
And the novel liposuction removed a whopping 1 kilo of painful dead weight from Megan's arm.
850 mils of that was fat and 150 mils was fluid.
Today, a lymphedema measuring device has tracked amazing results.
The drop in circumference in my arm is huge.
The liposuction procedure will provide huge relief from pain and swelling, but it's not a cure for lymphedema. That may come, though, with new trials of lymph node transplants about to start here at Macquarie University.
I've bought a new coat already, and I actually haven't worn a coat in over 4 years.
Australian mushroom growers are shedding light on a new superfood. Exposed to UV rays, the sun-blessed variety is a potent source of energy-boosting vitamin D.
Small business owner Lisa Costanza feels the effects of the midwinter blues. She spends most of her time indoors and is lacking in vitamin D.
Makes me feel very tired and not able to do what I want to do because my energy levels aren't there. Makes me feel a bit down.
An unlikely quick fix could be a revolutionary magic mushroom. The new sun-blessed variety is infused with vitamin D.
And as the pre-pack goes through the machine, it gets a flush of sunlight and there we have it. The skin changes the chemical combination in the mushroom to the vitamin D.
Regular mushrooms are grown indoors and don't contain any vitamin D. This new technique replicates what would happen outside.
They're very safe to eat because the same as what you'd find in nature, so like a wild mushroom.
With about one third of Australia's population now deficient in vitamin D, these sun-blessed mushrooms are a healthy and cheap remedy. Nutritionists say all you need is 3 a day.
The super mushrooms cost about 10% more than regular varieties. They're cheaper than vitamin D supplements, with the same power to prevent a raft of deadly diseases.
cancers, heart disease, high blood pressure, even things like depression.
The mushrooms are now available in Adelaide and Sydney. By the end of winter, they'll be in grocery stores across the country.
Three mushrooms a day and you're on your way.
Kate Freeburn, 10 News.
A new pill approved in Australia is doubling the life expectancy of some melanoma patients. Cancer doctors say the results are spectacular.
As Marie Caracusa's family was preparing a 50th birthday bash for her last August, doctors told her a lump in her abdomen was melanoma and it had spread to her liver.
My GP said to me, basically, look, I would probably advise you to get your affairs all in order.
Marie decided to go on a trial for a new pill called vemurafenib. It acts like a guided missile seeking the cause of 50% of all melanomas.
Called a BRAF mutation. And this drug targets that BRAF mutation and stops the cell in its tracks.
Within days, Marie felt better. More significantly, all tumours throughout her body have now disappeared.
Maria had a spectacular response. She was one of the patients that really did very well and is still doing really well.
Only 5% of melanoma patients respond to standard chemo. With the vemurafenib pill, 50% of patients see tumours shrink, which has doubled their survival rate.
So this is an incredibly important step forward for treatment of metastatic melanoma. It's been a desert for 40 years.
Because the new melanoma treatment is designed only for those with a mutation of the BRAF gene, patients will have to have a genetic test to see if the treatment will actually work for them. And currently, the company making the new pill is providing the test free.
It's currently approved only for advanced cancer. For Marie, it's been life-changing.
It's like it's almost unbelievable, but I'm just so excited that there's something out there, because not only is it a little bit longer, but I think it's more than a little bit longer.
And a group of teenagers has been given a taste of how severe their hearing loss could be if they don't turn down the volume on their headphones. And leading hearing experts warn if we're not careful, new technology could send us all deaf.
With teenagers, warnings can often fall on deaf ears. But not for these kids. They're listening carefully to a leading hearing loss expert.
If you were listening to sound at that level through your iPod for 25 years, this is what your hearing would be like.
Oh no.
In this exercise, students are getting a chance to predict their future hearing loss. The plea from Professor Peter Blamey: turn down the volume and step away from the speakers.
There are one or two apps now that you can buy and download to your device, and they will monitor the amount of sound exposure that you've had on a daily basis.
And his warning is being heard loud and clear.
I'll turn the volume down a little lower, so that, and I'll listen to, not to like hardcore music.
But I'll try and keep an eye on it from now on.
Oh, put earplugs in.
Perhaps nobody in this room understands the importance of hearing more than the young lady behind me. 15-year-old Rafi Barrett was born with profound hearing loss, but just last year she received a cochlear implant. Where once just chatting to classmates was a massive challenge, today anything is possible.
Rafi hopes by sharing her story, she'll encourage others to protect their hearing.
I don't want them to go through the hardships and struggles of having such a low hearing. It's just really exhausting.
A message hard to ignore. Gabrielle Boyle, 10 News.
And that's this week's look at the health of the nation.